They say the eyes are windows to a man's soul. What do they see in mine? Is there anything left? That's my boy, Johnny. He don't sleep much. I once heard a story about a boy who grew into a man, who knew love, true, deep, unconditional love. Was it all a dream? Or did it really happen?
Once was a boy who was happy, who was loved. His eyes burnt so bright they could outshine the sun.
You're growing so fast, you told me once. I think I even saw you cry. Looking at some old photographs. I think of you sometimes. The way the sun always shone through your hair. You looked like an angel. My angel. My hero. My mom. Dream. I dreamt you left me, and I broke into a million pieces.
until one day, on a shore he knew so well, the boy laid his gentle face upon the grains of sand. He closed his eyes and felt the warmth of the sun caress his skin. He let sleep take him away with promises of far-off lands. He floated deeper and deeper until the sound of distant thunder awoke him. It was dark and cold. He shivered, looking around him. He reached for his mother's hand, but she was gone. He was completely alone. Where was she? She had left him.
I thought time would last forever. There would always be tomorrow. But I was wrong. Time faded. It faded so fast. It tripped the both of us. It has a funny way of doing that. It tricks and hurts. It takes it all away. We are born to expire. We live to experience. But somewhere along the line, we forget her promise. Time always wins.
And fall from the sky, his wings torn, crippled, walking alone on a path he did not choose.
I'm standing on the edge. No hand to save me. No way to turn back. Where do broken people go? Is there a place for us? Followed my path today, and it led me back to you. So here I am, trying to get home. I'm standing just feet from you. I know you're right there, but this distance, it's greater than both of us. Can you see me? Do you know me? I miss you, Mama. To fly away from here and never look behind.
On a cloudy day, just before the rain fell, he stood by the water's edge and counted the waves. The boy said a prayer. He put it in a bottle and set it off to sea. He watched the waves become an ocean and take his faith away. No miracles. no cure. And he walked 1,000 miles that day, until his feet bled. He was tired. He was broken. He was looking for hope. But hope would not come. It was courage who reached her hand out to him. But he was blinded by her strength. He did not see her come. He did not see her go.
Some days are diamonds, and some days are rough. You taught me that. But today was not a diamond, and it was more than rough. I lost it all. You held my tiny hands in yours and taught me to be strong, but I just don't think I can. There's so much I want to say to you. All the little things I took for granted. Nothing means what it did before. I was blind. I was foolish. And now, I am nothing. I am feeling troubled. Lost. I lost it all.
And when nightfall came again for the seventh time, the moon whispered her name. The boy raised his eyes to the light and pleaded with her. He fell to his knees and wept. He had to find her. He had to save her, wherever she was. He would put on his armor and go to battle. For her, he would fight dragons and demons and devils and thoughts. But he was weak today. Weaker than yesterday. He could not lift his sword. He was fighting shadows. And the moon looked upon him with pity. She saw his sorrow, his youthful face. She closed her eyes and waved goodbye. And again, the boy was all alone.
Held me up in your arms and told me I made you happy. And for that one second, I was the happiest I'd ever been in my tiny little life. Always in your shadow, always safe, always near. Her hands, I can't stop thinking about her hands, her gentle, loving hands, the hands that loved me, that cared for me, that showed me the way. Her hands, the hands that taught me, that cooked for me, that made me laugh. Her hands, so frail, so weak, so beautiful. Her hands that held me tight and made me complete. The hands that carried me, wiped away my tears, healed my scars and picked me up when I fell down. Her hands. Her hands.
The moon then reappeared and the two struck a deal. Walk by the creek, she told the boy, and I will follow. But do not drink the water. The boy took her word for truth and walked till daylight came. But he was thirsty. He was dying. He reached his hand into the creek and something pulled him down. He fell into a darkness, into another world. She had once given the boy a coin. He knew it to be special. It had brought her luck. He hoped it would do the same for him now. Thank you.
Doctor is ready for you now.
I don't know how to describe what you're experiencing here. It's a situation beyond your control. Your mind has created a psychosomatic condition, making you unable to speak. Many may argue it's not a mechanical issue. More of a mental block. I disagree. I believe the mind controls everything. It can allow us to do wonderful things, but it can also shut us down. And this, what's happening here, I believe we can do something about. My methods are unconventional, but I do believe I can help you.
Then the boy saw a tunnel and raced for the distant lights. But when he reached the end, he came to the beginning. This strange new world. A labyrinth. So tilted. So warped and mangled.
Oh, darling, it's so nice to see you feeling better. Maybe you can get back to doing some of your writing. That book's not gonna write itself, you know.
Sometimes I want to get washed away, swallowed up, never have existed. And some days I wake up and I want to feel so alive. I want to light the world on fire, to fly like a bird and look into the sun. But it's not real. Nothing is. Nothing matters. For there is no forever. And time, you sweet seductress. You drank with me. You laughed with me. But you wrinkled my loved ones and ached their bones. You turned off my dreams and kept me awake. Then laughed at me. So cruel. Untouchable. But like a faithful servant bowing to your grace. I wanted more. Time never stops.
And then the boy met three devils. They were red as fire and rose up from the water. The first moved closer and looked looked into his face. No eyes, no ears, no mouth to speak. And the boy closed his eyes and took his deepest breath. He ran ahead through fire. He had to get away. A storm is coming. The devil spoke somewhere in the distance. The boy stumbled, the boy fell, the devil laughed, and all the light in this strange new world faded and disappeared.
All the stars fell from the sky. I'd gather them up so I could shine. Maybe you'd see me from above. Maybe you'd smile. Trapped in the four walls of my mind. Who would have known? My own mind. My own best friend. My own worst enemy.
Oh, darling, it's so nice to see you feeling better. That book's not gonna write itself, you know.
I don't even recognize myself anymore. Not even my reflection. I don't fit in anywhere. I don't know where I belong. A storm is coming. When will it rain? I I can hear the distant thunder. When will it rain?
It was a long time before the boy opened his eyes again. Hours, years, decades. When he looked down at his naked body, he did not recognize his limbs, for they were the limbs of a man. He stood up on his feet and walked to a mirror. He did not recognize him. His eyes were the same, and so was his mouth, but he was not a boy. He had become a man.
Φάερε λάλο σου φάει τα μακαρόνια σου ρε. Πάτα να δυναμώσεις σαν τις βρίζες του δέντρου ρε. Φάερε να μείνεις έτσι παστό ρε. Να σε παίρνει ο αέρας. Φάει. Mm-hmm.
She's leaving me. My boy, too. There's so much I want to say, but I'm empty. I stand at the edge of the world, wondering what to do. My thoughts have turned on me. My mind has silenced me. My will deserted me.
Day by day, he looked at his reflection, turning grayer, turning to stone. And his heart weighed so heavy, not a sound, not a noise, not a hope. And he wished for a friend with his stony, cold heart, who could break down the walls of this cave. And when nightfall came, she whispered his name, his old friend, the moon, in the sky.
I see you in the waves. I hear you in the wind. Had your faith to pull you through. Why can't I find mine? I'm floating. Nowhere. For even on the brightest day, my light has gone. I miss you. And I will till I take my very last breath. I miss you.
And a red glow pulsed where his heart used to be, and he looked up at the moon. Run, she called out. They are coming for you. And she showed him a door to break free.
asking, have I been here? Have I been here long? Have I been here for quite some time? I'm falling. I'm falling.
To the other side.
I see no light. No darkness. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? No darkness. No light. Can you hear me? Alive. Able. Strong. Potent. Null. Suspended. Hung. Unconscious.
Dormant.
Dormant. Confused. Idle.
Resting.
Inactive. Darkness. No light.
Yeah.
So he ran and he ran from this desolate place, running deeper into the shadows. Then he dropped to his knees where nobody could see, and the three fire devils came closer. No, yelled the moon as the devils approached and a light from the sky hit the ground. Run faster, she called. You can make it, my boy. And he turned with a curious look. For the voice he just heard was one he knew well. His own mother's sweet, beautiful sound. So he gathered his strength and ran for the light, where he found a large sword and a letter. So he picked up the blade and twisted around to the devils standing before him. Oh, and how the three laughed at the tiny small man and his courage alone with no army. Then the mane of the three moved closer to see the red glow where a heart should have been. And the tiny small man, using all that he had, stabbed the devil deep in the eye. And it screamed a foul noise, and the rain fell down, drowning all of the devil's fire. The sky opened up, and he looked around for the letter his mother had left him.
I can't breathe. I can't breathe. I can't breathe. I'm gonna tear these clothes off, for they do not fit me. I'm gonna shed this skin I can no longer carry. I need help. I need help. Someone help me. Someone help me. Please. Someone help me.
He read the first line. To my precious boy. And knew she had always been with him.
Mama, mama, mama.
I once heard a story about a boy who grew into a man who knew love, true, deep, unconditional love. And yes, it really did happen. Because that boy was me. And to this day, I still remember my mother's words from an old Christmas card she had once given to me. To my precious boy.
Take good care of all that's good in you. Give with all your heart to those who need your help. When you have lost, let go without sorrow. Live with honesty, not hate. I want you to be a good man. I want you to have a good life. And believe in yourself, even when things go wrong. Tell yourself you can. I am always beside you. even when you cannot see me. I love you. From the day you came into this world, till the end of time, I love you, and that's forever.
This time, from a lifetime away, I wonder what she would have thought of my life, of all the things I have done. I close my eyes and wish I could go back to where it all began, and do it all again. Thank you.
Thank you.